Three members of parliament, led by Chankwanzi District Woman Representative Christine Ndiwalana, Michael Mawanda of Igara West, and Muhammad Chibedi of Mitiana North, who recently introduced a motion on the floor urging government to rescue the private schools financially before the reopening in January, appeared before the committee and justified their motion.
We have given the statistics that the government does not have the capacity to absorb all the students. For example, we have 7 million students going senior one. Government cannot even take 10%. So where will the rest go? Private schools. So how can these private schools be assisted to absorb? So there is a role they are playing, and we need to work together.
If we don't help the opening up of the private schools, where are all those people going to be taken in schools? We looked at the percentages here, whereby in primary we have 48. That's not very bad. But in secondary school, it's 77. Those are all private schools. If we don't assist them to reopen, where will our children go?
77% of secondary schools are private. In primary, they are 48%, 73% tertiary level, whereas pre-primary level is 100% private. MPs contend that government alone can't manage to run the sector without private schools. They asked the committee that each private school at least be given a loan of 100 million shillings for renovation and pay back the money in 5 years after the reopening of schools.
This 100 million, this figure has arrived there to assist, as I say, institutions to open. You have seen government saying students should start now preparing. The revenue, unlike government schools which get capitation grant from government, private schools don't. They now look to the owners of the schools.
Lawmakers have refuted allegations that private schools charge high school fees than the public ones, with evidence that majority of government-aided schools in Wakiso, Luwero, Mukono and Kampala charge heavily more than private schools.
A secondary school in Kampala here, a government-aided, you'll find that it's charging 2 million shillings. A government-aided school with all facilities. And a private school in the same location is charging 1.7 million shillings. So it should be a two-way traffic. I won't mention the schools, but we know, we live in Kampala here.
The school fees charges, which my colleague has clearly stated, in our earlier submission, we did indicate and show that private schools instead charge less fees. This one is not a hidden information. It is, you know it as parents. Government schools with all the facilities that are given by government, which I don't want to go into detail, still charge. You will see school fees, say, as 35,000.
The MPs, led by Abigaba Mirembe Katbat, the vice chairperson of the committee, also Luwero Woman Member of Parliament, now Kenya Brenda, want assurance that if the schools receive relief, they will reduce fees for the new term.
The issue of saying that we provide incentive to private institutions, personally, I would support it. But I want to see how the rest of the stakeholders in this business will benefit from this incentive. For example, how is the ordinary parent that he will be required to pay full tuition if this incentive was given and the school is open? How is this parent expected to benefit from this incentive?
Reducing tuition, school fees, especially in the opening, was addressed by the proprietor. They said that at least they would allow for the first term on reopening to either parents to pay like not as much as they've been paying because of the problems. Because we are discussing the same matter, that how does it help the parents?
This incentive is supposed to benefit schools. What do we mean by the school? It is the teachers, it is the workers, it is the students.
In case this committee approves the motion of supporting all the private schools with 100 million shillings, it could benefit over 4,000 private schools. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.